Hey everybody, welcome. My name's Ishas Jolly. I am the product sales engineer for Mercedes-Benz Vans. We're here at Work Truck Week at the Mercedes-Benz booth, and I'm super excited to show you the all-new eSprinter. The all-new eSprinter is our version of the electric journey. We are excited to talk to you about the electric versatility platform. This is a newly designed platform that was used by Mercedes-Benz Vans to produce this vehicle. This vehicle is produced actually, or is going to be first produced in Charleston, South Carolina. It's got an impressive combination of load, range, efficiency, and I can't wait to tell you more about it. All right, so let's go to the front of this van because I want to show you what the three modules are with this van and what essentially it has to offer. So the first thing I want to talk about is that onboard charger. That's essentially going to be right behind this Mercedes-Benz star here. If I pop it open, you'll essentially see that's our combined charging socket. That's going to be both AC and DC capable. So let's start off with the DC. Right here, if I pop that little flap, that's going to be your entire combined charging socket. It's going to give you DC fast charging capability. So if you go for our optional fast charger, it can give you up to 115 kilowatts capability, which means that from 10% to 80%, it's going to take you about 42 minutes to charge this van. That's impressive. Considering the fact that it's such a large van and it's got such a combination of load, range, and efficiency, I think that's really great. If we then move over to the top part, it's actually going to be our level 2 charger, so that's just this part here. And that's essentially going to be our AC charging capability. This van is going to be AC charging capable up to 9.6 kilowatts. What that means is that from any wall box charger that you might have at home, for example, you can plug it in and it'll give you, it'll take the charge of the vehicle from 10 to 80% in just north of 12 and a half hours. The other thing I wanna mention is when you actually charge this vehicle, you will have two indicators to let you know that this vehicle is charging. First, you will have an audible lock symbol that will actually show up right over there to tell you that the cable is locked in with the vehicle. And second, you will have a visual indicator by this light. This light will go amber to let you know that the vehicle is charging. And as soon as it goes green, it lets you know that from the outside that the vehicle is fully charged and ready to go. All right, so that was the onboard charger. I want to take a moment to talk a little bit more about some of our drive modes and regenerative braking, I should say, that this vehicle is going to offer. Essentially, these are two functionalities that this vehicle is going to give any driver the flexibility to completely control how efficient and sustainable this van can be. So let's go over to the front cabin and let's have a look. So when I open this door, the first thing you'll notice is that it's still feels like that premium interior Mercedes-Benz Vans product, right? Two things that I wanted to talk about. First was regenerative braking. This vehicle is regenerative braking capable, and what that means is it's gonna be able to recover a lot of that wasted energy when you're braking, which will actually take that power back into that battery and actually charge that battery up. That's obviously gonna be great for efficiency. The way you would manage those modes is we have a max regenerative braking mode, and we have 5 different modes all the way to sailing or coasting mode. So the regenerative braking modes are actually utilized, or you can actually change them through the paddle shifters that you can see right here behind the steering wheel. Shifting down will actually take you to the max regen braking mode, and that'll actually mean that you've got the maximum energy being recovered into that vehicle and giving you that total optimal efficiency when it comes to battery range. Shifting up from the other side of the steering wheel is actually gonna tell you that you can get to the other side of the regenerative braking spectrum, and that'll give you sailing mode or coasting mode. And what that means is essentially there's no regenerative braking happening in this vehicle anymore, which means that for different topographies or terrains, it's gonna give you maximum flexibility to ensure that your driving mode or behavior is as comfortable and efficient as possible. The second thing I wanted to talk about is something called drive modes. Drive modes are essentially something very similar that you might have in a car today. We offer a eco, a comfort, and a max range drive modes. And it's actually conveniently located underneath the start stop button in this van. When you press that drive mode, it's gonna give you an option of comfort, eco, and max range. Comfort mode is gonna be your maximum performance from the motor, as well as the HVAC heating and cooling unit in this vehicle, which means that you're gonna have no compromise there when it comes to performance. Moving over to the other side of the spectrum with max range, this is going to be primarily focused on conserving battery range and essentially limiting some capability of the HVAC unit and motor capability. A key thing to note is that if you do kick down that accelerator pedal, you will get the max performance of the motor regardless of what drive mode you are in. And lastly, we have in the middle an eco mode. The eco mode is gonna be that real good balance between max performance and max range, essentially giving you a comfortable drive time with no compromise in terms of HVAC or power capability. All right, so let's go ahead here and talk a little bit about the motor of this vehicle. This is gonna be essentially the brain and the power delivery of this van to get that vehicle in motion. So the motor is mounted on a rear module that's actually located right behind the rear tires. The motor comes in two different power variants. One is a 100 kilowatt standard motor, and the second is a 150 kilowatt motor, so you have either or option. The 150 kilowatt motor is more for maximum performance and actually will have towing capability as well. The motor is a permanent magnet synchronous motor. What that means is that the stator has got magnets all around itself, and that's gonna give you that maximum and very quick power delivery and torque delivery when the driver requests it. The other thing I should mention is that because it does have magnets, it doesn't have any windings, which means that it's actually gonna be maintenance friendly as well. So that was the motor. I really wanted to take a chance to now talk about the battery. So let's go check it out. All right, so this is the battery that was in that van that we just saw. It is a 113 kilowatt hour battery, and the cell chemistry is a lithium iron phosphate cell chemistry. That's great for two reasons. One is that the lithium iron phosphate actually is free of cobalt and nickel, which is some rare earth materials. And secondly, lithium iron phosphate actually has a lower cell degradation, which means that the maintenance of this battery is going to be a lot really good over the course of its lifetime. Speaking of maintenance, the battery warranty on this is going to be 8 years, 100,000 miles, with an optional service contract extension up to 185,000 miles, which is very impressive for this side bag. This battery essentially is the brains and the meat of this van, and it's going to give you that range that we talked about earlier. It is going to be mounted underneath the van on the center, which will give you that really low center of gravity, ensuring that that vehicle is stable at all points on the road. So that was the battery, and essentially that will then ties off the three modules that comprise of this all-new eSprinter. The all-new eSprinter is actually going to be launched in the second half of 2023. It's going to be launched as a cargo 170 wheelbase high roof, and actually going to be produced for the first time in the U.S. in Charleston, South Carolina. So that was what we had to offer today. We are super excited for this next phase in our electric journey. Stay tuned for more, and I can't wait to be back on video.